as far away as it could. Now, what do you think of President Erdogan's calculations at the moment? Will he be very supportive of the Putin agenda, or he will just follow his own agenda very strictly?
I think the American politicians are supporting this idea and let Turkey away from NATO, but especially Erdogan seems that these ideas and some parts of the United States Congress are under effect of Israel policies, but Turkey especially not. There are some points disagree with Russia also, like the Black Sea issue and the Crimean Peninsula from Ukraine issues. But we can say that Turkey has been working with Russia, but doesn't mean that Turkey is undermining the alliance. We agree with Russia on several points, especially on Syria and the arms deals, but there is no shift in Turkish foreign policy. The Erdogan is showing to U.S. that he has local collaborations in the region, especially named this a strategic partnership. Turkey, as a NATO member, has a strategic allies with United States, but United States is facing with a new, brand new problem that a NATO member, Turkey, is getting Russian arms, and they have saying that a threatened to NATO and US arms if Turkey get these missiles from Russia. So the conflict is on the not Russian and Turkish sides. I think American politicians should understand that this is the 21st century, and a NATO member can deal or agree with a non-NATO member like Russia or China or Iran.
Despite the independence of the Turkish foreign policy, what about your attitudes towards Kurds in the Middle East, particularly those who have been left stranded in Syria? Now, what would be the end game of the military drawdown by the Pentagon? Will President Erdogan be allowed by Moscow to attack Kurds whose ambition for establishing its own country, despite the autonomy of those Kurds in northern Iraq? What would be the picture like? Our friend in Ankara, please.
This is the so sensitive issue on the table with Putin and Erdogan's agenda. United States are planning to establish a terrorist region in the borders of Turkey in from Syria, from Iran, and from Iraq, so till to the Mediterranean Sea. And Turkey and Russia, and also the regional countries, Iran and Syria, don't let this. So Turkish army is ready to attack the terrorists components in Syria. So Turkey announced this before, and the American politicians like Pence, they are rejecting these attacks to Syria, but Turkey urged that this is a critical and for Turkish next years it's an important surviving point. And let me say another important point: Turkey is doing operations with Russia in the Idlib area, and also going to do operations with the east part of Syria with the U.S. Army. So it's an interesting point that Turkey, if decided to make an operation, will not ask the United States about this, but will coordinate with Russia, Iran, and the other regional countries. So this is an important agenda for Turkey to not to wait U.S. policies to establish in the region. Turkey will establish its own policies with the border countries and Russia.
Now, Tel Aviv, or the Israeli state, is known for being the strongest ally of the U.S. government in the Middle East as a democracy. Now, given the fact that the 2019 is a year of election for both President Erdogan and Prime Minister Netanyahu, given the pressure of setbacks in the local elections in Turkey, what do you think of the presence of the Israeli military, the national defense, which vows to fight ISIL in Syria, and that has caused some troubles? Will the Israeli strikes be a major issue for not just Russians, but for Turks as well?
The policies of Israel Prime Minister is rejected from Turkish side, especially on Al-Quds and other components. And Turkey says irresponsible. Netanyahu can't change the West Bank status. This is all about the elections. But in these years, the Erdogan has thinking that the Israel policies are shaping the Trump's policies in the region. So don't reject these cooperations at the northern Iraq, Iran, and Syria. Turkey has relations with Iran that is banned from Syria and even United States. And Turkey has some conflicts still with Israel, and Israel is supported by the United States. So this is an ongoing problem with United States and NATO dealing with Turkey. Even, you know, United States is given the F-35 airstrike fighters to Israel, but rejecting to give to our paid F-35
that's indeed a big pity for Ankara not to have an F-35 at this moment because of your decision to have a S-400 air defense system from Russia. I'd like to go back to Pavel. Pavel, we've been discussing, you know, the issue of the Kurds and President Erdogan's political agenda at home, and part of that is, of course, to present a tough face to Kurds in Syria, where Kurds wants to have their own homeland. So what do you think of attitudes of President Putin? Will he give a green light to President Erdogan's military maneuvers in Syria?
Well, that's not that straightforward an issue. It's not easy. Russian and Turkish interests have somewhat clashed in Idlib province. The Russians would want Idlib, the last stronghold of the anti-Assad opposition, to be taken over, the anti-Assad forces expelled or surrender, and the Assad government take over the country, including Idlib province, which the Turks are reluctant to allow. And Russian Moscow, Putin have, actually against some advice from the Russian military, Putin agreed with Erdogan that Idlib could wait, because for Putin, apparently, Turkey and Erdogan are more important than what's happening in Syria per se. And of course, Russia was an ally of the Kurds on and off for almost 70 years, supporting the Kurds against local governments in the Middle East, were seen as pro-Western. Now, and still, even right now, Russia has in Moscow, there's a semi-official embassy or representation of Rojava, the Syrian Kurdish entity. But I would believe that in the end, Russia could even sacrifice its connections with the Kurds if it got Turkey in exchange. Turkey is much more important. So, but this is going to be a very delicate bargaining thing between Erdogan and Putin. What a